Greetings and good day, YouTube and Twitch Highlight Watchers. How are you doing today? I myself am pretty excited because we are at part two right now of the series for YouTube, which is probably going to be like, what? And possibly 10 parts, depending on how we go today in this 24 plus hour stream. We are going to check out what we can buy and start by, what the hell is this? Rapid fire pulse gun developed by Takigawa Harmonics destroys targets with sustained high frequency oscillation, making it especially suited for canceling out pulse defenses, which use the same technology. Okay. Oh, a new laser blade. We can't use it. Combo attacks that sweep through the surrounding area. It's got more attack power and impact than our current laser. We need something that generates more energy for that. New training missions, let's do them immediately. Intermediate support 3 tetrapod ACs. Intermediate mercenary support is provided by All Mind. Okay. Cool. Oh, is this? Yeah, this is a four-legged. Tetrapod leg units have high loading capacity and enable AC builds equipped with multiple heavy weapons. Tetrapod ACs can switch to hover mode after setting off the ground, allowing them to remain suspended in the air for some time. Alright. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Wild. Ricochet, really? Rude. How about that for a ricochet, jackass? And then we just ran out of energy almost. Wow, okay. I like this. Hovering-based tactics. High altitude in turn, making it easier to establish a line of fire and lock on without geographical obstruction. Okay. Oh, really? Okay. So we can in mid-air dodge. That's wild. It takes up energy, of course. But that's kind of wild. I damn. Okay. Got a grenade launcher. Tank ACs. Now, these, if I'm not mistaken, are some of the highest capacity AP you could get a hold of. Right? If you do a tank AC build. Yeah, look at that. 16,000. Okay. Tank legs units are heavily armored and boast excellent loading capacity. In addition to lending themselves to highly durable builds, they are also good candidates for high firepower assemblies. Tank-type ACs are capable of absorbing recoil, which allows them to fire heavy weapons without entering a fire stance. Oh, tank. The tank controls are weird here. Like, we have to... Oh, that's weird. That's weird. Oh, we have Gatling guns. We have miniguns. Drifting. Tank type ACs can drift to quickly change the direction they are facing. Oh, shit. Alright. Yeah, these types of ACs are ones where you don't give a shit if you take damage. To an extent. They're not very good at dodging. At all. Then again, I'm fighting two mini-bosses, basically. Not allowing you to have any aerial capabilities in an AC is like, it's a death sentence. If you can't get in the air, especially in a game that has such high mobility like this, no way. Mind you, the tank goes very different from what I'm used to, so it would take some time to get used to using a tank. Well, see, here's the thing. I don't know. Advanced Mercenary Certification. Pass certification. Assemble your own AC and complete evaluation. But yeah, I don't think we are course corrected like that. Alright. Adaptive assemblies. During real missions, you can expect enemy reinforcements and other changes to the situation. The test of an advanced mercenary is their ability to adjust to a wide range of combat scenarios and adapt their AC assembly to meet the needs of the mission. Next. We gotta be careful with this asshole. He wants range. Ricochets. He's got a shield. Ah, okay, that. Ow. No shield for him now. We gotta wait until he blasts at us with that three prong. Now we can charge in. it. Ah! I pressed square way too late there. Now we gotta fight an AC. Yeah. Okay, we passed certification. Let's go.
Incoming comms.
Ooh.
Congratulations on your certification. You have proven your skills by completing the entire combat training regimen. Registration number RB23. Call sign, Raven. All Mind anticipates excellent performance.
Yeah, what are you giving me for doing that? So there's no more training. Advanced Mercenary Emblem. Alright, cool. Cool, 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 cool. Arena rank F. I want the arena so bad. Retrieve combat logs? Okay. And then the investigate boss area, arsenal number 2. And then we have the replay missions we can do later. Well, we got the battle log. This one being pending confuses me. Yeah, whatever. Let's do the retrieval of the combat logs. This doesn't seem like it's gonna have combat at all.
621. One of the Balaam companies has put in a request.
Attention, Gun 13 Raven! This request comes from our affiliate Dafung. We're conducting an investigation into the Vespers, Archibus's augmented human squad. Currently, our focus is on their fourth squad leader, V4 Rusty. Sweep the route Rusty took during Operation Wall Climber and retrieve combat logs from the...
We might have to fight Rusty.
The wall is now under Archibus's control, and they stationed their MT squads there for the Coral Survey. As such, he'll be targeting the brief window where their main force is deployed elsewhere. Keep an eye on the time and retrieve as many logs as you can. That concludes the briefing.
Might have to do this one a couple of times. Yeah, he probably lost a couple of people on this, on that, the wall mission. Because it was like an open thing, and then they just... Oh, like I said, I didn't expect combat on this one. But yeah, I don't think the weapons... Like, there are certain things that they won't allow you to do, right? If you have the tank stuff set up, you probably could fire your weapon without going into a stance. That's what's really interesting about tanks in this game. I don't know how midair works. I think midair you can do certain heavy weapons without...
Search the nearby wrecks for combat logs.
the wall we found in Galia is going to dry up the well sooner than later. We just can't harvest as much coral as we used to, and what little we do get, the corpse squeeze out of us. I know we need it to raise mealworms. How many more children must we watch starve?
Some more evidence on what the coral situation looks like.
Steel haze allows one to discern the assembly of Rusty's steel haze. Steel haze appears to be assembled from a Schneider high mobility frame equipped with weapons that allow for swift, agile action. Rusty appears to favor kinetic weaponry that Vesper's members would not normally use.
50%.
This is useful.
Very. Those missiles do not blow up quick. Like, holy shit.
That makes three logs.
Can't beat the top Vespers. We're as good as dead. At least Zyria is off duty. She's the Liberation Front's little sister. She doesn't deserve to be out here on the battlefield. She can still love and be loved, have a family. Oh.
Worthless.
I knew what he was gonna say. Holy shit, they took one out. I know who you, interesting.
Very interesting.
Yeah.
This could be worth something.
Yeah.
Two repair kits remaining.
Where, oh where, are these other logs? Ah, there we go.
You, AC pilot, you're no comrade of ours, are you? Wait, you killed them all!
No, I didn't. Something hidden? Her out to get her log as well. Nice shield.
Fuck. AP at 50%.
Whoa, watch that one. We hit her. You had half health already, and I'm not. The timing was impeccable on that. The shield went down, and I was in. No data regarding offensive or evasive maneuvers detected. Okay.
Nothing we can sell here.
Oh, nice reversal.
Ah!
Oh, no! Me getting stunned fucked me!
Arcabus's main force will be here any minute now. We've got enough logs to satisfy the request.
We got it. Hopefully we got the... Yeah, we did. Okay. That should be all the logs possible. There might be a log up there, too. We might have to do this again to get the logs. This is not one that's worth a lot of money. We'll have to see if we got pending. That might mean there are more logs that I missed then, if it's pending.
Two new messages.
Who? Oh my. We're popular today.
Gun 13 Raven. You bagged us some decent intel on V4. I'll report this to Commander Michigan. Additionally, I'll introduce myself. Gun 6 Red. But you can call me Sir. I'm privileged to be among Balaam's best, even if I am stuck whipping you independents into shape. Believe you me, I'm gonna put you to work.
Registration number RB23. Call sign, Raven. Your records have been updated. Granting authorization to perform ACOS upgrades.
Hey, let's go.
Additional. All Mind hereby invites you to the Arena Combat.
Yeah, there we go. That's what I was waiting for.
The Arena is a virtual combat simulator designed to support the development of registered mercenaries. It also serves as a benchmark to appraise and rank the mercenaries active on Rubicon. We look forward to your participation.
Expand OST chips in your possession to upgrade your AC's OS from the OS tuning menu. Upgrade the OS unlocks features and improves functionality. They can be obtained in the arena. Boost kick? Huh. Manual aiming. Quick turn's probably really good. Damn, okay. Okay. System unlocks, core expansions, attack control. Access speed getting increased would be nice. Melee weapons, though. Oh, yeah, no. This is going to be interesting. Now, arena. Fight virtual battles against copies of ACs created using All Mind's mercenary craft data from the arena menu. Win arena battles to obtain OST chips. Opponent AC data and opponent emblems. You can use OST chips to perform OS upgrades. Alright, so we have Invincible Rummy, AC Mad Stomp. A member of RAD, Doser Fraction, like many other Dossers or Dosers, Rummy is utterly addicted to coral-based drugs. And in his perpetually addled state, he has convinced himself that he is an invincible demigod. Even should reality intervene with a costly defeat, he will forget about the setback entirely by the next day. Only death can dispel his notions of invincibility now. The lore of the arena ACs is so good. Now we have Index Dunham, AC, Burn Pickaxe, a guerrilla leader of the Rubicon Liberation Front, a blue-collar worker who was involved in the construction of the grid. He is now dedicated to establishing symbiosis with the Coral and building a future for Rubicon free from planetary closure. Inspired by Father Dolomen's ideals, able-bodied and eager, he is zealously dedicated to the cause, but he is more at home in the construction yard, than the cockpit. And G6 Red, who we just was talking to, AC Hermit. Gun 6 of the Red Guns, the Balaam Group's AC squad. As a young boy, Red's life was forever changed when he saw the news broadcasts of Commander Michigan's brutal triumphs in the Jupiter War. Red trained through blood, sweat, and tears in order to emulate his idol, supporting his impoverished siblings all the while. When the Balaam admission examination finally came, he won his place in the Red Guns at the very moment he stood to attention to greet the squad. Let's kick all their asses. But the AC lore is so good. And the music. So the arena's set in stone. That's kind of unfortunate.
First subject AC. Mad Stomp. Call sign.
That's cool. I like that. I like this.
Commencing evaluation.
It's got a lot of AP for sure.
Activating combat mode.
He's got a shotgun. Like I said, we're gonna kick their asses. Once you start to get a feel for the controls, stuff starts to flow. It's amazing how well they did this stuff because it, like, everything's flowing just so well. Verified. 50 seconds. Oh no. Oh no. This might be a mainstay for a while because of the online. If the on, like, I'm expecting it below arena is gonna be versus or something like that. Oh, we can keep fighting them to get, like, small amounts of money, it looks like. That's all good. I mean, I'm liking the build we got so far. I think we're gonna stick with it. Go through these arena fights and then go from there. Probably do another mission or two.
Arena Combat Aptitude Evaluation Program, number 28, rank F.
He's got a big ass cannon, subject a burst fire and machine gun.
Burn pickaxe. Call sign, Index Dunham.
He's also probably gonna have some ricochets, maybe, because of the design of the AC. Then again, I don't know if these ACs can ricochet. Oh, yeah, it's a big-ass cannon. Missed both, I think? Also, the arena's RNG. Yeah, he definitely is not an AC pilot, or he is an AC pilot, but he's not a skilled one, unfortunately for him. I have to overwrite the previous design that we had. Also, what new shit do we have? Another new cannon, it looks like. Cool. Is that it? No, it looks like we have this as well. We might have to make ourselves a couple of different mechs here in a moment or two, because, looking interesting. We could do this for the reduced energy load. That would allow us to maybe switch out what weapons we use. Maybe use the different laser sword thing. No, whoops. We have less health now. No, just a shortfall, unfortunately. Oh, it only has one consecutive hit, it looks like. What? Charge the weapon to increase laser output, enabling combo attacks. I'm gonna buy it, but we're not gonna use it yet, at least not for the lightweight mech. We'll have it in our back pocket and
Arena Combat Aptitude Evaluation Program.
Get ready to use it later.
Rank F. Final evaluation. Subject AC, Hermit. Call sign, Gun 6, Red.
Pistol and a cannon. With some missiles. Evaluation. We can fuck him up with our laser. Got him once. Ah, shit. Yeah, we're fucked. If we get hit by that.
50%.
Okay, so he's
AP at 30%.
He's at 50, so that pistol is a lot more damaging than I thought it was going to be. Like, holy shit, we need to try and stay as far back as possible. We won. It was close. It was close. That pistol fucked us up. But it was definitely close. Hilariously enough, if we did it, that those missiles would have probably taken us out.
This concludes F rank evaluation. Well done.
Damn. Okay, there's gonna be some ridiculous fights in the future. That was tense. That was tense. Like it a lot. So, did we unlock more arena fights or no?
Incoming comms.
Finish our first water bottle of the evening.
You have surpassed rank F. We are glad to oversee your development as a mercenary. All Mind exists for all mercenaries.
Oh, it looks like we gotta wait till we do more missions. We could keep grinding the fights out to just get like 20k here and there, which is nice because we're not spending money on repairs and shit. We just win. We get 20k. So, might not be a quick 20k, but it is an easy 20k. Now, we probably want damage mitigation to start. Control during assault boost. What is that on the controller? Oh, so this allows us to have, instead of rockets, it allows us to have another weapon. Interesting. Interesting. I'm trying to think about what button that would be on the controller. Control tab. Sure, why not? We'll do that. Then we'll go and do AC test and see if we can't figure out what buttons do what for quick turn and stuff like that. Because if we have quick turn, that will help us a lot in the future. I have no idea what the quick turn is. Just tap the boost to do the kick, that's fine. Oh, it's circle. No? So you press, okay. So it is circle for the quick turn. It's just, there's like a weird delay on it. Okay, okay. I like it, I like it, I like it. I am going to step away for a moment to go to the restroom and get a thing of water after when I return. I'm also going to remember to run ads this time, because that's what I've been meaning to do every time I step away. When I come back, we will be investigating boss arsenal number 2 with our current mech, and if we have to change things up, we will. However, I'm gonna step away. Be right back. Alt tab. Hopefully it won't be too annoyed by me. Run a couple minutes of ads. And when I return, like I said, I'm excited. There's probably gonna be a lot of grinding we're gonna do. I have no idea how much time it would take on average to beat this game, if you just like were to focus on playing the game, but we'll see. Be right back. All right, water bottle has been replaced. So now we can continue with our adventure. So yeah, so far I'm liking the how the story is going, right? We don't really know our background at all. Also, we should probably change our AC name, in all honesty. I think what we're going to change the AC name to is going to be... Nope. Can I not use my... created emblem? There we go. That's what I wanted to use. We need to fix that up. I like the eye. I need to upload my my little icon image. Oh, cool. Okay. I'm a little disappointed at the, like, you can't actually play any videos or anything like that, right? Like, you can't play the audio logs. It's literally just written out for us. That's kind of a shame that, like, the video logs just show you a general look and that's it. AC design, AC data, save, yes. Interesting. So we actually unlock. Okay. That's pretty fucking cool. And then we could download other people. I'm very interested to see what some people come up with. I'm not gonna really change the AC name yet, but we'll figure it out at some point. I'm just doing this to get rid of all the notifications that we have new shit. I always dislike notifications that are like, hey, you have new shit to deal with. But yeah, so far, we don't have a... 621 is our name. We don't know our history. We don't know what. Wait.
We believe you are more than a corporate pawn. Perhaps we can even work together.
So after ripping the wall from them, they're gonna give us a job.
Baus Arsenal number 2, a major MT factory in the Bellius region. The Baus Corporation sells to anyone, but they've been essential to maintaining our firepower. Now, their second arsenal has gone silent overnight. If it were only a comms failure, a simple check-in would do.
But it's not. Look at all the error codes.
After the Strider, more cautious voices have gained influence.
This is Sorry about that. Moment,
but would appreciate your help.
Now here's my question. Are they gonna give us, like... So in Armored Core 3... There was like a set in stone path you took. I wonder if this one's going to be a set in stone path or if it's going to like potentially allow us to veer off course and like either stick with the corporations or go with the Rubicon Defense Force or whatever the hell they're calling themselves. We'll stick with what we got. I don't see no need to change. Basically, until we like start failing a bunch. I think our mech design's good enough.
The unexpected.
Expect the unexpected. You could have gave me any bit of other advice other than what I'm already going to do, Walter. Really?
Main system activating combat mode.
Commence mission. Investigate Baus Arsenal number 2. I've been checking the perimeter. I'm picking up nothing. What happened here?
Interesting.
It's too quiet.
Hold on. I don't know. I'm taking a look, and I'm assuming that this is the air conditioners. I mean... Yeah, they don't look that good at all. The way the ductwork is set up and stuff like that. Mind you, I guess I'm not gonna get too complaining, because unlike with a lot of other games, this one, you, like, are really not focused on this. Like, you just walk over it and it gets fucking destroyed. So... It's not really something to keep your mind on, but I can't help but take a glance at it. Oh! Another beautiful example of our size difference. A regular car. Compared to us. Whoa! It's invisible.
621, watch its shots and see where they're coming from. Of course, MDD. Stick to it like glue. You'll lose it if it gets too far.
Okay, now I'm interested. And it's not that he's invisible, it's that he's got that cloaking. The stereotypical... Think about using the scanner. The scanner is something that I am not used to at all. Sit down, bitch.
Unidentified machine down. Keep going and stay sharp.
Two repair kits remaining.
I need to use my shield more often. What am I doing? Why do I even have it if I'm not gonna use it?
According to the blueprint, there's a massive water reservoir deep inside the arsenal. If there's anything waiting for us, that's where it'll be.
Yeah, it is a little noticeably faster. You cheeky fuckers. These things are fucking intense. Eating more than I want to here. Blew up. Okay, good.
All clear. Keep going, 621. Is that response? 621, get down and take a closer look.
This is probably going to be a hell of a fight. This is a massive open area.
No
boss fight.
It. This water.
Oh wait, I think I know what this boss fight's going to be from one of the
it
commercials.
Faint traces of coral. Must have been an underground vein. Bows was hiding a well all this time. Thank you.
Fuck.
Three of them. No, four. You're outnumbered. Pick them off one by one, 6-1.
Fuck! Get off the fucking... This is one of those moments I was talking about. This is a tough mission. Ah, we missed. That sucks. That miss sucks. Come on.
Another dealt with. Stay focused, 6-1.
Where? There you are. Wait. Where? Shoot at me, you asshole! There you are. Use your shield, dipshit.
AP at 30%. Light shoulder ammunition at 30%.
Like I said, that's a tough fight. See, the goal is to get through an entire mission without using any repair kits, right? That's like how I think you would guarantee an S rank. I could be mistaken. I don't know how much damage you'd be able to take. Because you do have repair kits, so maybe they change that. Maybe a repair kit or two is fine.
Long hey. Time no see, Walter. Looking good for a change. I see you've got a new augmented human. What happened to 617 and the rest?
Their jobs. They did what it took to get us here.
Huh. So how's the newcomer doing?
Adequately. But Gen 4 augmentation can be unstable. We need to choose our battles. How's things on your end?
I found the data our friends left behind. There's something promising in the watchpoint.
So that's basically like stuff that we 621? We 621 don't care. That's like for the players' benefit more, obviously, more than the players. So now we're gonna be talking to Cinder?
I see you back, 621.
Walter.
About the coral well that was found at Baus Arsenal number 2. That was just a drip coming from an underground vein. It won't last long. It it's not the coral we're searching for.
We don't get S-ranks. Hold on.
I've sent you your next job. This one isn't from the Corps or the Liberation Front. You'll see when you check the briefing.
That's gotta be Cinder, then, that we're getting this mission from. No, we only get our ranking for missions when we replay them. Right? This one's gonna be annoying to A, S rank. We'll be able to do it, but I just need to not take hits. And I need to find the battle log, but I'll look into that. There's so many battle logs I'm missing. And you also have to keep in mind, lightweight mechs have this tendency to be more for mobility than armor and stuff like that. So we're probably taking more damage that way as well. Attack the watch point. So this is Spider, or I keep saying Spider, but Cinder.
Personal request from a friend of mine.
Oh, really?
It concerns a certain facility, a watch point. Once it regulated the underground flow of coral. Now it serves to monitor the dormant veins. I want you to attack it. Your objective will be to destroy the sensor valve at its core. The watch point is kept secure by SG, the planetside PCA force, which means it's too hot for the corporations to be seen there. In other words, we're flying strictly solo on this one.
This is probably the hardest. This is like the first wall we're gonna come across. We have no distractions. This mech is not, I don't think, gonna be good for it, but we'll find out. I need to use my shield more often. This mission will conclude chapter one. We'll try it with our lightweight and see what we get.
You'll be going in under cover of darkness. Be ready for anything.
Or throw a wrench at me or whatever. Now, the dodge training comes naturally as you just keep playing the game. That's something that comes naturally. And in a game like this, you're going to take hits, right? It's not about never taking any damage at all, right? It's about taking the least amount of damage possible.
It's go time, 621. Don't worry, not even the PCA would anticipate a solo independent mercenary. Get in there and get to work.
Main system, activating combat mode.
Leave no evidence. If anyone sees you, handle it.
Code 1-5, intruder sighted.
It's just one AC. Who are they with?
We can look into that later. Engage.
Fuck. Okay, let's mulligan that. That fucking thing hits. As soon as it charge up, it hits you. Holy shit. Okay. Those weapons up there are fucking insane.
Leave no evidence. If anyone sees you, handle it.
I guess rid of that threat.
Code 7-8, requesting backup.
I can't get through to HQ.
The cavalry isn't coming. Wipe them out, 621.
That's the plan! So these are high proficiency combat MTs that I'm going up against. You would think that a facility like this would have multiple ACs protecting it. Or at least one.
Enemy squad destroyed. Move on to the next area.
Where did that AC come from? What happened to the patrol squad?
Code 1-8. All units deploy for combat.
You're exposed to snipers from all quarters. Keep moving or they'll shoot you down.
AP at 50%.
Ah, fuck.
Code 3-1-C, we've taken critical damage.
Updating your marker data. Proceed in the direction indicated.
But yeah, this... The way the movement is and everything flow, it feels good. You know, like, it feels really good.
You see that? That's the Watchpoint's control center. The target's inside. Make your way in.
Here we go.
Attacking a Watchpoint.
Scylla.
You're incorrigible, Handler Walter. How many of your dogs must I kill before you learn?
Is that... Suma?
Pitiful dog. I feel sorry for you. I really do. You may have survived a little longer. If only you had a different master.
C-1249. Suma. He's an independent mercenary who survived first-gen augmentation. Don't think twice, 621. Kill him before he kills you.
Hit him twice.
We're 619 and 620. Dead? Which ones did I kill, I wonder?
Don't let him bait you. Focus.
Trust me, I'm good.
One, repair the information.
He kicked me. Fuck! I forgot about the kick I have. No, we are one of Walter's hounds. We're basically... Oh, we're dead.
At 30%.
We're gonna have to checkpoint. This is the first time we've had to checkpoint. Here's your difficulty example. We're not even halfway and he took us out.
Was it worth it, Walter?
Damn.
Their blood is on your hands.
They're calling us a dog, and it makes sense that they are, because we're not doing these missions on our own volition. We're doing the missions because Walter's having us do this, right? So we are one of Walter's dogs. This is going to take a couple of attempts.
You see that? That's the Watchpoint's control center. The target's inside.
I gotta make sure I use my fucking shield, too. That one is the reasons why we took as much damage as we did. We can skip this time.
Suma. Pitiful dog. I feel sorry for you. I really do. You may have survived a little longer. If only you had a different master.
C-1249. Suma.
I can kick too, bitch.
621. Kill him before he kills you.
We're 619 and 620.
If we can push him in the water.
Which ones did I kill, I wonder?
Don't let him bait you. Focus.
Fuck, that hurt. Fuck!
Fine hounds with the right training. Shame you'll have to die here.
Oh, the water. You
remaining.
Never mind. We've won this one. Guess who keeps forgetting to use their fucking shield? I should use the kick first. Oh, fucking hell, man. This is gonna be a rough one to S rank. If you miss that, don't go for the second.
Walter, stay away from the watch point.
Confirmed. Enemy AC destroyed. Forget about him, 621. You did good today.
Did we?
Back to work. Penetrate the control center and destroy the target.
Oh, a resupply. Damn it. Okay, so this is a long mission then. Like a really long mission then, because anytime we get a resupply, or we're about to fight a boss? Really? Interesting. We're about to fight a boss then. If we just got a resupply. Oh yeah, we're about to fight a boss. Ain't no doubt about it, we're about to fight a boss.
Job 621. We're done here. Head back to base. Wait, no. 621, get out of there.
Some sort of coral discharge?
Who are you?
We're talking to an AI right now.
Augmented human, fourth generation. Have we made contact? I am Air, a Rubiconian. Please, you must wake up before your consciousness is forever scattered in the coral flow.
All right, so we got some interesting shit. Whoa, okay. We got some interesting, like, fucking psychokinesis shit going on, or whatever the hell you want to call it.
Augmented human C4621. Vital signs confirmed. Disabling autopilot. Establishing comms link with him.
Raven. I've identified an approaching enemy.
Oh.
I'll synchronize with your brainwaves. And maintain contact to support you.
Shit.
Reactivating combat mode.
Whoa! Okay! Okay! Hello! We gotta take our time with this one.
Evasive action, Raven.
Okay, this is gonna take a couple of attempts. We're gonna have to change up our AC, I think. Where? Where? Comment you asking about the difficulty? There's your answer. There's your fucking answer. I don't think the shield's gonna help us on this one. And they don't fucking stop coming! Holy shit! We only took a couple there. Motherfucker. Okay, I get it. We gotta change our AC. We gotta let ourselves die, basically, because that bar around him is an anti-melee. I'm gonna let him kill me. I have no idea how to avoid all those missiles. Oh. That's interesting. I don't know if we're gonna be able to do this with what we got. Dual pistols, maybe? Plan B is, missiles and pistols. And see what happens. Pistols aren't working. They're ricocheting.
Picking up a massive heat signature. Evasive action, Raven.
How?
I'm sorry, Raven.
No. The amount of missiles he's firing at us doesn't matter. Yeah, tactical reloading isn't the issue, game. Thanks for the input, though. But trust me when I say we're getting hit is the problem. It doesn't matter. Well, yeah, I get what you're trying to say. We need to figure out how to avoid the brunt of the attack. Probably what we need to do is go back farther.
Reactivating combat mode. I've looked into the enemy craft. It's an autonomous PCA craft, Bounteous. You'll have to break its pulse armor to inflict meaningful damage.
We get hit by that, we're fucked.
Repair kits remaining.
Picking up a massive heat signature. Evasive action, Raven.
That's how we avoid most of that. Okay, got it. Got it.
Pull summer down. Now's your chance, Raven. I've taken your comms link offline for now. That massive dose of quad nearly killed you.
We got it. It's the missiles we got to figure out how to just avoid. Fuck, man. He just overwhelms you with the amount of missiles he can fire at your ass. He really can. This is probably our first wall. We might have to actually... Yeah, we're gonna have to figure something out. It's the big burst that fucks us.
Picking up a massive heat signature. Evasive action, Raven.
Because we're still getting hit a little bit. We gotta avoid that. We get hit by that, we're fucking dead. Nope!
You have to focus on winning this.
No repair kits remaining.
We gotta stay at range. We're gonna have to grind and get a different build going for our mech, I think. I think we avoided every single hit there. I think we didn't take a single rocket. We took a little bit. Not nearly as much as we did before. Fuck that attack! Fuck that attack! That attack is so fucking fast. That's the one that's gonna fuck us up the most, I think, now. Here's the other problem. That fucking shield, man. We're gonna have to grind out shit. No, not anymore. They used to be able to have that, but that would not, even that point defense system would not help us. The only thing that would help us is the decoys from the older armored cores. So this is what you call a wall. That is a wall for us. We'll have to figure out what is gonna, like, we're gonna have to grind out other missions in order to make enough money to do a different build. And then we'll have to do that mission again. The biggest thing here is I think we're gonna need to get one of these. For canceling out pulse defenses, which is what that thing has. One of these will probably help us a lot because it won't have the shield for nearly as long, I don't imagine. You know? We figured out how to avoid the missiles, at least. So this is where we start having to grind a little bit, right? Because if I start going to the parts shop and I want to look at stuff to buy, like, what would be a good thing to go for? Maybe something like this? Or the plasma? Could do some laser cannons. Well, yeah, but honestly, I'm okay with that because it's not, the missiles are not too much of a problem to dodge, I'm noticing. What the problem is that cannon. I don't think a tank build would help us out. Maybe a tetrapod build would. But I don't know. It's heavier. It's twice as heavy, almost. Lower output for energy, but it has a higher capacity, a higher recharge, and a quicker supply recovery. Yeah, capacity is not really what we want to go for. It's definitely like recharge and recovery is what we want to go for. This is actually a better head to utilize. Apparently I have other parts. Oh. Yeah, that's what we want. These rounds seem to have a tendency to ricochet. That's fine. But now we're at the part in the game where it's like, hey, time to grind out missions, get money, get shit to build better builds.
The client doesn't care who does this job, as long as it gets done.
I can look around the arena next time we try that fight. Which, it'll be a minute before we try that fight. I'm kind of glad we came across something like that at the end of Chapter 1, you know? Because that's, like, a perfect example of, like, so far, we've had a couple of difficult moments, but this was, like...
Commence mission. Destroy all of the Rubicon Liberation Front's artillery placements.
The biggest example of... Like, hey guys, that's what you gotta worry about. You gotta worry about, like, fucking end of chapter bosses. This build that I got going on is actually kind of wild.
You're up against mass-produced MTs. Eliminate them as necessary.
Enemy attack! They're after the artillery! Fight back!
Head to the final site. Keep up the good work.
That was a little bit overkill. Thank you. That should be us done. We got there. S rank. Yep. Figured. We did that so fast. More than likely, when I do end up getting the logs, it'll probably be after I look them up. Then again, we could just go into the mission and spend as long as we want in the mission after we S rank it. No reason to, be too bothered by it. I mean... They probably wouldn't go through caliber at that point, right? Because there becomes a certain point where millimeter is the terminology just utilized across the board, right?
Main system activating combat mode.
Okay. Unfortunate. All right. I wonder what a speedrun of this game is going to be like. I wonder if one will be out by the time I get done with this game. That's my curiosity. That's my curiosity right there.
An AC! Where the hell did that come from? Affiliation unknown. Shut it down!
Picking up signals from AC, Rex. Follow the markers.
Yeah, that's the size of the helicopter. It's something that can drop MTs or ACs. And these licenses are set up at like the corp license and stuff like that. That's a little bit of lore right there, just without.
Duffung and Schneider are on the move. Grid won't be safe. Corp AC.
Like, without getting too into detail there. Because in Armored Core 3, you open up by doing a test, right? What's it called? A registration test to be a pilot, a Raven, right?
It's still valid, but the pilot's rank is no good. We can't use this. I've picked up one more wreck, 621.
Damn, missed.
Transmitting marker. Go and check it out.
Please.
You can use that vertical catapult to get some altitude.
All right. Anyways, yeah, in Armored Core 3, what?
Try accessing the wreck.
The hell is hitting me? That's annoying.
Registration number RB23.
But yeah, it's interesting to see that, like, there's licenses that are, like, focused on corporations and stuff like that. Fuck, that was a bad mess.
It doesn't matter. Take it out now, they won't have enough to ID you.
I don't think we're gonna get an S rank here.
AP at 50%.
We've got them now. They can count 621.
The first one I don't think should have missed. We're gonna have to do this mission again. I'm just gonna restart the entire mission from there. That's not, there's no way. We get a little bit of money, but that's not why I'm even doing it. If I wanted to grind out money missions, I would grind out the big one. I dodged one of the three or four missiles or whatever the fuck they're called. Love that.
Patch it up. See the contaminated city down there? That's where you're landing. Access the catapult.
It'd be faster to use all four of the,
picking up signals from AC Rex.
Probably ignore him, too. Way faster to ignore. I wonder if there would be out of any out-of-bounces or anything like that that they would utilize. More than likely, all I can imagine is that they would want to go for stuff that would allow them to, go fast and not really give a shit about taking out too many entities.
Looks like they've got shields. Good thing you've got a blade.
Like, I'm talking about speedrun strat stuff, basically.
Extract the pilot data. I'll analyze it from my end. This one's already expired. Keep looking. What?
I wonder if that did anything.
Analyzing.
We completed it. I was worried that we fucked up.
Easily traced. Forget it.
Dolphin and Schneider are on the move. Corp AC.
Wait. Is that an independent?
You're outnumbered, 61. Use your missiles.
I like the sound effect, how easy it is to tell if we've taken out a robot because it makes like a weird twang sound.
Let's see about this license.
Like that metal twang? It is nice to see how fast you can do missions. I should have dropped a little bit earlier than that. Oh well. don't know if we got an S rank on that because that last hit we just took. We fucked him up. But I don't know if we got an S rank.
Confirmed. Heavy combat helicopter is down. That's all for our work here today, 621. Here's the call sign from that license you picked up. Raven. That's your new name here on Rubicon.
Hey, we did get S rank. Let's go. Yeah, we need more. We need to get past the chapter to unlock more arena fights, I would imagine. Yeah, we're gonna have to change up the energy stuff. Different core we're gonna need. Go for something like that. That's the only setup we can do without setting up something differently. We can do some more mission replays. And I am going to have to look up battle logs because I have no idea where they would be at, possibly. If there even is any. It just doesn't make sense to me that there's, you know, not, but whatever. We'll skip this because we already watched this. We basically know everything there is to know up until the point where we fight that missile launching boss. I could have replayed the other missions a couple times, but I really want to like get past chapter one at the very least. Oh, Okay, so that cannon's actually gonna...
I can't get through to HQ.
Screw us over.
Cavalry isn't coming. Wipe them out, 621.
This is a closer range weapon.
Enemy squad destroyed. Move on to the next area.
That cannon, it slows us down. If we had a tank tread thing going on, we could use that cannon without it stopping us. So that's a little bit of a detriment.
What happened to the patrol squad?
Code 1-8. All units deploy for combat.
You're exposed to snipers from all corners. Shoot you down.
AP at 50%. AP at 30%.
Gonna have to change up our mech build a little bit. Might want to I don't know if we can dual wield. That does a lot more damage than you would think.
We've taken critical damage.
That thing does a lot of damage too, so.
Proceed in the direction indicated.
It is interesting to see how this story seems to be going along, though. Like, I didn't expect the random individual to come along and be like, hey.
The target's inside. Make your way in.
There's my question.
What?
Can we beat this person without dying?
Sula. Pitiful dog. I feel sorry for you. I really do. You may have survived a little longer. If only you had a different master. S1-E2. Sula. He's an independent mercenary who survived first-gen augmentation. Don't think twice, 621. Kill him before he kills you.
Right hand and ignition at 50%.
We're 619 and 620. Dead? Which ones did I kill, I wonder?
Don't let him bait you. Focus.
Eight.
Auto Gen 4's lot. I hear you make fine hounds with the right training. Shame you'll have to die here.
No repair kits remaining. 30%. Right hand ignition at 30.
Another dead dog.
The cannon is what fucked us over. This part's troublesome. Having to wait for the little you died thing in order to go to your assembly is a bit annoying. I like the sword. Dual wielding though does have its benefits. And I'm gonna try to see if I can do it without the other thing. But whatever.
Sula. Pitiful dog. Feel sorry for
actually what I should do.
You may have survived a little longer. Well, you had a different master.
Repair kits remaining.
We're 619 and 620.
So we should never stop firing because of the way that I have it staggered the way that I do. It's a shame that it doesn't seem that you could do, like, change your assembly when that thing comes down, or when you're in a supply point, right? Like, it would be interesting if you could, like, decide to change your assembly here. Because it does that, right? So you would imagine you should be able to, like, change up your robot. Then again, it's just resupply, so... There's no way for me to get out of here. There's no way for me to get out of there.
Good job, 62.
System reactivating combat mode. Looked into the enemy craft.
Fuck.
It's an autonomous PCA craft. Frontiers. You'll have to break its pulse armor to inflict meaningful damage.
That big ass fucking can is what's fucking us over.
Picking up a massive heat signature. Pulse armor down. Now's your chance, Raven. I've taken your call sync offline for now. That massive dose of coral that would have killed you. Please, you have to focus on winning this.
Two repair kits remaining.
Fuck you, up the ass! We can knock the shield down pretty significantly with that. I wonder what the hell is classified as close range. That's what we like to see. We can do this time. We just gotta fucking run away from him, I guess. When he gets to that phase two. Holy shit. This game is fun. Oh, fuck, man! That.
Main system, reactivating combat mode.
Maybe we gotta go closer than I feel? Be more aggressive. Just be on their ass, man. Where are you?
Thank you.
That's starting to get a little annoying. So as soon as we get to phase two, we're gonna have to just back main off system. And...
reactivating combat mode. I've looked into the enemy craft. It's an autonomous PCA craft, Bounteous. We'll have to break its pulse armor to inflict meaningful damage. Picking up a massive pulse armor now. Now's your chance, Raven.
That fucking cannon?
That massive dose of coral could have killed you. Please, you have to focus on numbers.
Two repair kits remaining.
He fucking did that before he did the other thing, the fucking cunt.
AP at 50%. No repair kits remaining.
Oh, we're dead. Come on, please! Oh, motherfucker. Fuck!
I'm sorry, Raven.
I need to use my missiles more. Oh, we ran out of weapons. I need to use my missiles more early on. We had him.
Main system, reactivating combat mode. I've looked into the enemy craft. It's an autonomous PCA craft, Bounteous. You'll have to break its pulse armor to inflict meaningful damage.
Pulse armor doesn't regenerate, doesn't look light.
Picking up a massive heat signature. Evasive action, Raven. Pulse armor down. Now's your chance, Raven. I'm taking your comm sync offline for now. That massive dose of coral nearly killed you. Please, you have to focus on winners.
The enemy has taken bitch! Yes! Ooh, there we go. Ooh. Fuck yeah! That's gonna take a while to S rank. Basically, we're gonna S rank that when we learn that fucker's every attack. Ooh! Let's fucking go. Chapter 1, complete, in 5 hours and 30 minutes.
Raven.
Give or take a few minutes for stepping away to go to the restroom.
I need rest.
No, I don't. I'm good.
But first, a warning. The coral surge
I know.
Swept up in. That was just a glimpse. Premonition of the storm of flame that will burn Rubicon.
Damn. Lot of ammo. Davlin Alpha. Detonating bazooka.
Observational data. Look, 621. The localized coral explosion caused by the surge has a certain directionality. It's headed straight for the central ice field across the Aulian Ocean. Like a flock of birds or a school of fish, coral loves company. Which means somewhere in the ice field, there's a huge mass of coral lying dormant. You said you could hear a strange voice in your head. That's a common side effect of old-gen augmentation.
Oh, bullshit.
Could also be from getting caught in that coral surge. Don't let it bother you.
Raven. The coral explosion completely vaporized northwestern Bellius' Bay Area. And even yet, compared to the fires of Ibis, that explosion was hardly a spark. Raven, I have a favor to ask. Let me remain in contact with you until we reach the coral convergence.
You're not wrong.
I have to see where they're taking us. How this struggle over the coral ends. I must, as a Rubiconian.
There's so much that's going left unsaid.
Augmented human, C4621, entering standard mode. Two new messages.
I've got some business to attend to. I need to hawk some intel to the corpse and secure a backer for our trip to the ice field. one job for you while I'm out. Rest up. And that's an order.
Hopefully we've got some arena fights or something like that to do.
Raven, I see your handler is away on business for now.
Iyer is gonna have us do some shit too.
About that trip to the ice field, we've received a job from Balin already. Let's take a look, shall we?
Registration number RB23, callsign, Raven. Your records have been updated. E-rank virtual encounters are now available in the arena.
Let's go!
We invite you to hone your technique.
New parts. So, oh, I like that. I like that. We'll have to figure that out later. I'm going to do another part here, I think, because we just finished chapter one. And it's been like 2.5 hours since last time. That, and I do have a couple things I want to say. We have no idea the Rubiconians here. Like, are they actual natives, or are they individuals that were sent here very early on? Because Rubicon is a planet everyone has gone to in order to get the coral, which has been discovered on this planet, right? It seems like, from my perspective, that this the fight or whatever, like, coral keeps generating mass amounts, and if enough of it gathers up, it has a reaction, an explosion. Hold on, let's click on this and see. We have E. So if it goes up, if it goes 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this would probably be D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. B. Nah. So I don't know exactly what it goes up to, but normally it goes up to like S rank, right? We're going to read all these in a moment here. We want to check our new parts and stuff like that. Ooh, an upgraded version of the previous assault rifle, right? Oh, shit. Oh, shit. We got the Gatling gun. See, getting unlocks like this is going to help grind out missions later, right? A handheld missile launcher. It's kind of wild. Is that what I think it is? Oh, it is a pile bunker. Ooh. 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 I think we want that. We're gonna have, I want to get every single one of these parts. I really do. Grenade cannon. Ooh. Weird. Weird designed helmet. Excellent performance in aerial combat. Interesting. Those are some big arms. Ooh. Might want to get these arms for this build. We need to build it. We need to get the tank and the spider legs, the tetrapod legs, not the spider legs, but whatever. New boosters. New FCS. Probably want to get this one. Eh, or this one. Medium range is where it's at. And then generator. No new generator, it doesn't look like. Well, this is a burst. This is burst fire, right? This is burst fire, and this is burst fire. These two are burst fire weapons. And you got to keep in mind that one of these rounds is probably as big as a person, right? Like, one of our feet, one of our little, like, feet, as you see, is as big as a car. So, like, this is probably something you would see on a battleship, for example, right? Or something like this. Like, we're able to hold around 80 millimeter guns. It is insane to think about. Like, this is probably every time you shoot, this is a tank round going off. Overburdened. We're gonna have to grind out missions now, I think. Now, mind you, the missions have probably gotten a little bit easier. Just a little bit. We're gonna actually do arena stuff first. But before I do that, like I said, I'm gonna do another marker here and wrap up for the YouTube and Twitch highlight watchers. It's a little bit early for the 3-4 hour marker that I'm trying to go for. Where the hell did that go? There it went. But it's a good spot to do that because we pretty much established what we have going on. We now have an interesting plot point. The coil is gathering together. And some massive explosion that's similar to the original fire that didn't wipe everybody out, but wiped out most of the planet's population, I would imagine. So, that same thing's going to happen again, it seems. And the companies are fighting for the coral, the natives, whether they were living here longer, like long before anyone from Earth showed up, or if it's something like people were sent out to colonize Rubicon, right? I'm not sure yet, but interestingly enough, I imagine that the lore is going to expand more upon what we got going on. Walter does seem to actually care about the individual that is under his employee, even though we're pretty much just like no-name indentured servants, for lack of a better word. It's interesting to see where things are going to go from here. I hope you're as excited as I am to find out. And for those of you that are watching on YouTube with the Twitch highlight, I do thank you for stopping by, and I do hope you enjoy. If you have and are new here, be sure to become a citizen today via subscribing to this channel as well as my main channel. Links will be down in the description below through all my links if you're watching on YouTube. Exclamation point links like so. If you watch on Twitch, be it live, the highlight, or the VOD, while it's still up there. Be sure to follow me on Twitch. Catch when I go live at 6 p.m. EST, EDT, Friday through Monday. Invite link to the community Discord, where you can always get the most accurate notifications of whenever I do go live. If I'm going to be a little bit late or early to stream outside of a half hour, or as long as I know I'm going to be late. As well as where you can communicate with other citizens of the kingdom. whatever else catch your fancy through all my links. And until next time, take care and have a good one. Bye-bye.